In this episode of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory, we'll look at the Canis Major region and show you how to find these beautiful deep sky objects. Messier 41, Messier 46 and 47, and the open cluster, Tau Canis Majoris. All right, let's go star hopping. Hey, hello, hi, and welcome to episode 10 of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory. I'm Dave Hearn, and I'm super thrilled to be your host. In this series of programs, we'll show you the most beautiful sights in the night sky and explain exactly how to find them with your binoculars or your telescope. So this week, we'll be looking low in the southern sky. We'll be finding some of the most interesting open clusters in the sky in the constellation of Canis Major, the large dog. Canis Major has many deep sky objects within its borders as the winter Milky Way runs right through it. But it's primarily known for containing the brightest star in the entire sky, Sirius, the dog star. Sirius blazes at magnitude minus 1.46. As we learned a few episodes back, the magnitude scale used to measure the brightness of stars runs backwards, with brighter stars having lower numbers. Sirius is so bright its magnitude is in the negative numbers. Here's an image of Sirius captured with the KPO reflector. The long spikes are due to refraction caused by the support vanes of the secondary mirror of the telescope, in this case, a Newtonian reflector. Sirius is actually a double star with an eighth magnitude companion dubbed Sirius B. The Sirius system is only 8.7 light years away, which is why it appears so bright. Sirius is the obvious choice as a marker for starting a star hop, while there are several other fairly bright stars in Canis Major, as we'll see. So let's get started on our first hop, which is right in the neighborhood, only two hops away. We're going to locate the excellent and well-known open cluster Messier 41. Move to the dazzling Sirius and hope it doesn't wipe out your night vision. Spend a few minutes looking at this blazing torch in the heavens. It's said to be blue-white, but it's so bright that there's really no other color visible. So onward to M41. Move down about 4 degrees to the 5th magnitude star, 15 Canis Majoris. Now make a hard right turn and move out about a degree and a half, and you'll see this massive star as it is Messier 41. M41 has a visual magnitude of 4.5 and contains about 100 stars, scattered over an area a little larger than the full moon. The brightest star in the center of the cluster shines at magnitude 6.9. On clear dark nights, M41 is visible to your unaided eyes as a hazy patch in the Milky Way. In your binoculars, you can almost see individual stars within it, and it looks great at low powers and small telescopes. So the constellation of Canis Major is shaped like an upside-down Y, with the three main stars being Sirius, Wezen at the center of the Y, and Adhara and the lower Aludra forming the arms of the letter Y. Our next hop will start at Wezen at the center of the Y, and we'll be searching out the interesting open cluster Tau Canis Majoris, also known as the Mexican Jumping Star. So are you on Wezen now? Good. Wezen is a 1.8 magnitude star whose name means weight. That's appropriate as it has a mass 17 times that of our sun. So to get started on our star hop, move down to the lower left to the 4th magnitude star, 27 Canis Majoris. There are two other fainter stars above and below 27, so don't get confused. So now move about 2 degrees to the left, and you'll find a 4th magnitude star surrounded by about 60 fainter stars in a very compact area. This is NGC 2362, also known as the Tau Canis Majoris Cluster. This one has always been one of my favorite open clusters. This cluster is located about 5,000 years away, and its actual diameter is about 8 light years. If we could travel there and view our own sun from that distance, its visual magnitude would only be 15.5. Amateur astronomers have named Tau Canis Majoris the Mexican Jumping Star because it appears to jump around in your eyepiece. I don't know if I've ever seen this effect, but I sure like the name. We normally don't end our episode with a tough star hop, as this one kind of is, with 6 hops required. But at least at the end, you'll be rewarded with 2 great deep sky objects. So let's forge ahead to locate a great pair of open clusters that lie very close together, Messier 46 and 47, just across the border in the constellation of Puppis. We can start right where we're at on Tau Canis Majoris. Normally you can start from Wesen, just like we did last time. So, lots of hops here across the dense Milky Way, but hang with me and we'll arrive safely. So let's start with a quick quarter degree move to the upper left to 5th magnitude 29 Canis Majoris. Now move up a degree and slightly right to another 5th magnitude star. Now move 4 degrees to the left and about 2 degrees up and find yet another 5th magnitude star. We're still in Canis Major at this point. Next, move about a degree and a half to the left and slightly down to find magnitude 5.6 NR Canis Majoris. Okay, now move a degree and a half upwards and a degree to the left to locate 5th magnitude FW Canis Majoris. Now let's move across the border into Puppis, down to the lower left about 2 degrees to find 5th magnitude KQ Puppis. And now for the last move, slide about a half degree to the lower left and you'll be rewarded with a large grouping of stars that'll be Messier 47. Visually, M47 is a large bright cluster of magnitude 5.2, visible to the naked eye again as a hazy patch in the Milky Way. There are about 50 stars in the cluster, scattered over an area of a half degree across, the same size as the full moon. The cluster is coarse and pretty irregular, containing interesting knots and chains of stars. But the better cluster, in my opinion anyway, lies about a degree below. From the center of M47, move straight down about a degree to a 5th magnitude star, then to the left about a half degree, and you'll spy Messier 46, a mass of about 150 stars, ranging from 10th to 13th magnitude. They're all pretty faint, but it's beautiful. And if that's not enough, you may also spy a planetary nebula, NGC 2438, within the cluster, closer to the outer edge. This alignment between the nebula and the cluster is optical as opposed to physical, meaning the nebula is actually in the foreground, lying several thousand light years closer than the cluster, which is approximately 5,400 light years away. So that's our 4 targets this week. We had a bonus in there with M46 and M47. We started out checking out the brightest star in the heavens, Sirius. Then we moved a little downward to examine the bright open cluster, M41. Then, moving from the bright star Wesen in the center of the Y of Canis Major, we located the Tau Canis Majoris cluster. Lastly, we trekked out into the maze of stars in the winter Milky Way, across the border into Puppis, and found the 2 excellent clusters, M46 and M47, with the bonus planetary nebula, NGC 2438, located in front of Messier 46. I hope you've enjoyed star hopping around the Milky Way. We'll continue to bring you these astronomy tutorials every week on Thursdays. They'll be designed to help you find deep sky objects that are up in the sky at the time we post them to YouTube. The reason we create these videos is to help beginning amateur astronomers learn the sky and get more enjoyment out of their telescopes and astronomy in general. If you have any questions or suggestions of potential targets in the night sky that you'd like to see us present, just let us know down in the comments section. If you found this video useful, please consider subscribing to our channel down there, click the thumbs up, and please share it out to your friends who like looking at stars. Also, as I just mentioned, please feel free to leave any question or comments below, and we'll be sure to respond quickly. Also, please follow KPO on Facebook, where we post all of our astrophotos and keep everyone informed about upcoming astronomical events. We'd love to hear from you to discuss all this great stuff up in the sky. All the links to these places, including our website, kpobservatory.org, can be found below in the episode notes as well. And finally, if you feel this video provides you value and you'd like to see more, please consider supporting us on Patreon, where for a couple dollars per video, you can support our efforts and let us make even more great astronomy tutorials just like this one. Well, thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time on Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory.